Hello, welcome back. Fittisane here, Caffeinated Gaming, and the theme for this week in Infinity Wars is going to be being new player friendly, or I guess newbie friendly. With all the invites coming in, we got a lot of new players, a lot of players that haven't collected any cards and also weren't backers, so they didn't get a ton of cards while the Kickstarter program was going. So this week, doing things to help out new players. Today, I'm just going to go back and do a few matches with my All Commons deck, and let's get right... Oh, I don't want merged. No. So, we're just going to play, and hopefully I can bump into a new player, and not someone with a really good deck, because that doesn't work too well. While we're waiting, briefly show the deck off. This is... not the right deck. There it is! This is a Genesis Industries, and... Descendants of the Dragons deck, it involves basically doing pump on oftentimes Invincible Defender. Not always, though. I did show this deck off in a previous video. Depending on the time of day, they might both be up, they might not. So we're just going to wait and see. I do use some things like Pilgrimage Monk for card advantage, and sometimes she can come out later in the game. And then some AoE damage from to deal with hordes. A lot of Conscripted Militia out now, a lot of Flame Dawn, so I gotta deal with that. And also for late game, we got Extended Operation. Can sit back, put it on a guy. I can put it on an Ending Drone that doesn't want to get sacked. I could throw it on a Secluded Constructor. It's usually my target, because it starts with a little higher life than maybe a Wealthy Noble. Can maybe throw it on a Defense Golem, but a lot of times Defense Golem gets chucked for someone for hit points. There are some changes I would make in a rare deck. I would have Angelify. I would have Mega Unit 01. Oh, is chat maybe working? Sort of, not quite. Chat's sort of working. What else would be in this deck if it was rare? I could probably actually go look at that pretty easily. But I will come back when I get a game and show, basically, see if we can get a win off of an all-common, uncommon deck. And here we go, facing off against Balthus 03. I've never seen the name before, so hopefully it's not going to be a really hardcore deck. And start out with a Wealthy Noble. Always good turn, first turn in play. Ditto from him. So one thing for new players. This Caretaker of the Young does not have to be in the support zone to be used. Her target has to be in the support zone, but she can be in command. Something I learned quite a while ago from playing my... the hell deck. Shrine of Victory deck. Yeah, that one. Alright, so I'm going to start with a Golem. He's got some mana coming into play. So, let's see. I got some mana also. I got a Wealthy Noble. I got a... Undo. I'm actually tempted to... Yeah, let's do this. Because of the main reason I'm doing this now is because of the Varroa Death Worshipper. I don't want him to get big while I'm sacrificing lots of stuff, so. Gotta deal with it now. Basically, now or never. And since he had initiative, I'm safe from that. I did not lose my Defense Golem, which is kind of what I really wanted to worry about anyway, so. I'll play an Invincible Defender from my hand. Drop that there. And then I'll put down a Wealthy Noble. Now, one thing I'm going to run into real quick is the fact that I'm going to lose my Secluded Constructor pretty soon if I'm not careful. He's got another guy in play. That's going to be annoying. Good. Balthus obviously realizes he doesn't have to deploy or whatever. Battleground. I don't know the new terminology. Okay, what can we do? Let's just drop that there. And bring an Ending Drone back. Turn 5, he could be bringing in Pack Leader. I'm actually going to back up his turn and just take my damage. There's not much I can do about it right now, and if I wait one more turn, I'll be able to do a lot more damage. Let me think about this for a second. The other option, of course, is the more obvious solution. I'm just hoping I don't get burned. Let's do it. Well, since you initiative, I don't lose my guy. I'll bring a... Do I want to bring a Pilgrimage Monk? Put a Wolf or a... that in play. So is this turn gonna take the beats?
Yep.
So we traded basically everything for everything. Although now he's got a Death Worshipper that's getting kind of out of hand. I'm gonna start having to pump my guy, and it's... My biggest advantage here now is the fact that I have been hitting his morale hard. What's the rarity on some of these cards? I don't know all of them. That's a common. I want to see the pack leader. Just go all out, activate you. I think I am. I need all the help I can get right now. Every time I lose a creature, I lose one, but he loses. But my guy gets two bigger, so it's kind of worth it. Now the question is, does Balthus put the Death Worshipper in the back and hope to sneak it through, or does he put it up front and try to see if he burn through my guy? So it's kind of a waste of extended operations. I only got +2/+2 off of it. Oh well. I'm gonna pause for a second. See, 6, 8, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 22. I'll take 24 damage this turn. I actually might do some undoing. Let's just go back. I'm gonna rethink this for a minute. I'm gonna go like that. I'm gonna leave it back and take one more turn. Ooh, I didn't know about Skrar. No one expects the Skrar. Well, it's pretty obvious what I gotta do now. The nice thing, though, is the fact that I can... do it that way. Alright, Balthus, all I have to do is eliminate this invincible defender and you win. You could zap it. You can't bounce it. Can't exhaust it. But you have just a couple of... You can assassinate it. You can death ray it. I think those are pretty much it. So some of the things that would help this deck in the future, again, Angelify, I've mentioned either in this video or the previous video. If I had initiative, I Angelify, he can't assassinate it. He can't death ray it. I'm safe. That's a biggie right there. That's probably actually the thing that makes this deck good against most decks, is the fact that I can do that. And it makes it a little more strategic. Then there's obviously some of the bigger guys like Mega Unit 01, really good card, especially in the change. All right, let's see what's going on now. If I can survive this turn, I probably might, be in good shape. If I can survive. No, I didn't survive good enough. Well, we just tied. So, there we go. Next turn, I would have been getting my first Pilgrim's Muck, or is she dead? No, she's gone. So she would have been coming back next turn, would have given me two more cards, and I would have had a 4 or 5 blocker. That would have been nice. Or is she 3-3? So he dies to morale, I die to health. And there we go, tie game! So let's do one more quick game. Is anyone happen to be going right now? No. I'll be back when I get a game. No, it's merged. Don't want to do merged right now. Alright, here we go, another game going. Against Azucar. Looks like going to be factionless with a little bit of GI support, so gotta be aware of the mortar cannon this game. And I don't have Sage 2 to help me either. Turns out I don't want to do this, so bring that in play. I probably should actually switch this out for a Genesis Construct. The theory for this guy is if I can get a second one in my hand, then they start cycling. If I had access to rares, there are other cards I would definitely be using instead. His deck looks like it's playing passive right now, so I'm not going to go on the aggressive for a minute. The militias will start coming, and then I'll have to rethink what I'm doing. And my guy's a 3-6. Oh, if I had finally had enough mana to do it. But I can give myself a defense golem. So now I got lots of hit points. The only thing I can throw about from his deck is Assassinate, which isn't till turn 6. So he's got a defense golem now too. And what can I do about this? I can... Let's see, I'm going to cannon fire you twice. No, maybe I won't. What do you think? That's only 4 damage. I think what I'm going to do is... I'm going to start extended operating my guys. Yeah, the militias are starting to pile up a little bit. He's going to get rid of my graveyard a little. That isn't a strategy that hurts me right now, so I don't have to worry about that. Now, I do have to be aware of the possibility of him getting a lot of constructs. Or conscripted militia. Derp. Let's get a defender and Sage 1 spell. Because I can't have Sage 1s, they're rare. That's not fair, that's cheating. There's my defender gone. Them's the breaks. Alright, I got a choice to make here, actually. I can Winds of War. If he backs his militia up and plays another one, A Sage 2 spell will not be enough. Or Sage 1 spell will not be enough. But I would also get the one from in here. Unless, of course, he moves it into play. I think I'm going to play it safe and I'm going to go with Winds of War. Which means first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to Sage 1 spell and then I'm going to Winds of War. That kills all those guys. That just gets rid of my stuff. And now I have my Unending Drone. But before I do that, I'm gonna draw a card, because I'm a decent player. There, bad bot. Better. Better bot. Wins the war again. Draw a card, get a defender out. Or a drone out. I'm actually trying to wait him out a little bit. Although I really don't need to, because his only limitation is assassinates, and it doesn't matter if I'm in support with assassinate. But if I wait one more turn, if I wait till I can do maybe do a one shot, that'd be okay. You got a wealthy noble. So what I'll do is I'll actually chuck the Genesis Construct at that noble, and then chuck this noble at that guy, and then this one at that guy, and then I'll take that. Lots of stuff just happened, but it was okay. Put that there. You go in front. You buy there. You are all the way in the back. I'm gonna Sage 2 spell. And I'll draw a card. Had to think about that one for a minute. That's gonna kill all his guys. All of his guys. He's gonna lose a lot of morale here. So he only needs to take 2 damage now. So I can effectively back a guy up. Backing up doesn't do anything against him because he doesn't have battleground elimination. So I can just start bringing things into play. He's got initiative. I'm just going to draw 2 cards. As my last point, I will throw it on the noble. There we go. And the reason for that is his initiative, which means if I were to bring guys out and start pumping, his effects go off first. If he wins of wars, my guys that I bring out are going to die. So that's why I chose to draw there. That's the game. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to more. Go look at the forums. There's lots of posts to help new players. Hopefully it helps some. And yeah, I realize it's a CCG and sometimes it's rough competing with guys that are playing a lot. Hopefully get matchmaking and chat going. That'll help a lot. See you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye.